So because we have understood what is JavaScript and it is not related to Java, like many people you know treat it just by the name JavaScript using of Java, so they think that it's somewhere related to Java, and so we understood this thing, and we also understood that you know why this is gaining popular since 1995. So now we are going to talk on syntax. Okay, a few things which I'm sure in this session it will get clear. The confusion and everything will be clear, and I will also show you the demo as well. Okay, so that there must not be any confusion in your mind. So when I say about syntax, the first thing is white spaces. See, in JavaScript, it's up to you. If you're providing the white space or if you're not providing the white space, it's up to you. JavaScript do not have any problem. It basically, you know, depends upon you. If you are able to read, then it's good. If you are not able to read, then you can provide the space. Okay, let me give you the example. I'm declaring the variable using let. Okay, I'm declaring the variable. By giving the space. So both are same. Okay. I'm not giving any space here. I'm giving this space here. Both are same. There is no difference. So generally, you know, you will use the white space when you're doing some mathematical operation. If you're not using the mathematical operation, or you are doing some mathematical operation, it totally depends upon you whether you want to give a space or you don't want to give a space. Let me show you one example. So because JavaScript is a scripting language, so we will write our code within the script tags. Opening and closing. And as I have taken the, you know, example, so okay, this simple HTML page, and I'm using the, you know, the script tag to write my JavaScript code. Let's go here, refresh. So you can see Prashant, Veer, Singh. I mean, there's no difference whether I'm providing the white space. Here I'm not providing any white space. Here I'm providing the white space here. And here I'm providing the white space here as well as the white space here. So there is no difference. The result is coming, right? So this point is valid. Second is case sensitive. Yes, JavaScript is case sensitive. Okay. So, yes. Let's see. So I have created two variables. One is with a small, starting with a small c, and the other variable with the capital C. I saved. Refresh. Oh, sorry. Prashant Singh. JSON JavaScript. Okay. So JavaScript is a case sensitive language, right? Now, identifier. So identifier means the name of variable. Class, method, etc. When you give name to any variable, class, method, etc. So these are identified. So this is the identifier. Okay. Now there is a proper syntax we have. So identifier name can start with the alphabet. Okay. For example, this. Or can start with, or can start with underscore, okay, or with dollar sign. Okay, these are valid. Okay, you can also use like person one. Person, and in between you are using one, I mean number in between. Okay, but you cannot use one person. Let us see your first and last name. Okay, okay, let's make change here. So, as this is the same code, we haven't changed anything. So, course name and make it like this underscore C. Okay, save your code. Call the data. Now, if I make it as here one, okay, it's coming in regular now, and you will see the error as well. It's coming in the regular, so it is invalid. Okay. Data is coming. Okay. So you have to remember that these are the valid way to declare a variable to, you know, I mean, not to declare, to give the name of the, you know, variable class or the method or, you know, anything. And these are known as identifier. This is invalid. Okay. And the value which you provide here, so fixed value, like this is the fixed value, right? This is known as literal. Now, one question I have is, you know, dollar sign you won't be using that much because this dollar, I mean, declaring the value by using the dollar, you will see when, you know, you're referring some DOM element. Okay. What is DOM? See, DOM means document object model. So when you're referring some, you know, some DOM element, then only you see, you know, that the developer will be using dollar sign. I'm sorry. So when you will be using dollar sign, you will be using the dollar sign mostly when you're referring some DOM element. Now, basically, people who don't know the DOM, let me give you some introduction. So when your web page load, the browser create DOM. Okay. For example, this is a document. Create here, template easy. Document. Okay. And then your root element. Okay. And how you write? This is the tag, right? I'm creating that, you know, the same page, and I will show you as well. Something like this, right? So all these are, you know, I mean, whenever your HTML or, you know, web page loads, this is how the browser create a DOM, right? And if you notice, HTML head body like this, right? Compare the picture with the HTML page, right? So whenever you're referring the, you know, any you know DOM, so you will be using the dollar sign. Okay. Now for this comment. So for a single line comment, we will use this. For a multiple, we will use this. And the closing will be like this. Okay, let me show you. So I am doing a single line comment right now. Okay, I saved. Go here, refresh, see. Gone. Right. And when I put a okay, save this and show. Okay, now I'm commenting this. So because, you know, I intentionally brought this here because it was not showing result. So let us see now. See JavaScript. Everything coming, right? Because once we commented there, that's why, you know, it was not showing the result of this. And if I put here, let me show you again. Save. And I bring this, bring this here back into position, save. Right? If I put this comment on this line, so it is because I commented this thing, so value is not coming here. And after that, you know, I'm presenting the value, it is not showing this value as well. So that's why I intentionally am putting here, save, right? Now, if I have to do the multi-line comment, this is the multi-line comment, right? Okay, any problem till this topic? Okay, now one thing more is semicolon. So JavaScript do not force you to use the semicolon as a line term editor. JavaScript is a very intelligent language. Even if you use the line term editor, if you don't use the line term editor, it's okay. Okay. Let me show you how. I'm removing this line term editor. And I'm removing this line term editor. And let's see the result. See. Prashant. Prashant is here, then Veer is here, Singh, JS, JavaScript study. So there's no difference if you use line terminator, then also there's no difference if you don't use the line terminator. See, there is a no difference. JavaScript is a very, you know, I should say, intelligent language. Okay. So now let's see about the JavaScript outputs.